Well, the march of ISIS across Iraq is raising fears of terrorism around the world. U.S. authorities are putting in place new security checks for passengers bound for American airports. Chief Business Correspondent Christine Romans joins us now with the details. Christine, they're being very public about this. What do we know, and why are they doing this now?
Well, look, they're saying it's not a specific threat. It's just the general intelligence trend toward Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula, trying to find new ways to take down airplanes, and specifically what they'll be doing, coming in from travelers coming from Europe or the Middle East to the United States. Take your phone, take your laptop. At security, you may be asked to turn it on to show the screeners that indeed it is what it is, what it says it is. There might be new kinds of detection machines and equipment to make sure that your laptop is a laptop. There's not a bomb-making device or a bomb device in there. There might be more scrutiny of your shoes. And you should be prepared if you're coming to the U.S. on a direct flight from Europe or the Middle East that even at the boarding gate, you might be tapped on the shoulder and asked to have another additional screening to take a look at your electronic devices. The focus be in shoes and electronic devices.
Shoes and electronic. Do we, first of all, we know this is going to result, it must, I mean, this is going to result in longer lines and delays at security. And do we know that they have all of the equipment in place? What's the cooperation like on an international level?
Jay Johnson, from who runs the Department of Homeland Security, he says, look, they're not giving the specifics on what they're going to do. Obviously, that would go against the purposes of all of this, but you can expect more scrutiny. And look, the TSA, to fly directly to the United States, you have to, a foreign airline, a foreign country, has to be able to say yes to the TSA, we will do these extra measures. So they have been talking to these other countries and these airlines to get this done. The whole point is to keep it safe, convenient, and safe. I know that's difficult when you're talking about international air travel, safety and convenience, but I think that the most important thing for air travelers, for me, is to make sure it's powered up.
Yeah.
What happens if you get there and your laptop's out of juice?
Which often happens, by the way,
absolutely.
Because you're done with your business or your vacation, you're worried about necessarily making sure
you're fully charged. Time to come out of the line, to find a charger, to plug it in, to open it up, to show them that it is what they say it is. There are other devices, too, that if they don't know what those devices are, and this has happened to me already, a child's DVD player, where the TSA has stopped me and said, what is
because we're so old-fashioned, I'm carting
around
one of those, too,
instead
of an iPad. But
you know what I mean?
Exist.
I mean, so you have some old clunky something. You've got to show that you know what it is and that it is what they say. All meant not for a specific threat. You know, it's interesting. Jay Johnson, who runs Homeland Security in the U.S., he was on NBC's Meet the Press yesterday, and he was asked, would this spread to domestic airports? And he said, I don't want to speculate on whether this could be a domestic initiative in the U.S. as well. So he didn't rule it out, which I thought was very, very interesting. It's all meant to be fluid and to change as the threats change.
And also, now we know something that's done in some parts of the world, very difficult in other parts of the world, is profiling. It sounds like they're going to profile you. And if they're not sure, they're going to pull you out and get another look at you. What do flyers need to know? Because this is sort of coming out now. People have flights that were booked. They may already be in the middle of a trip. Where can they get more information? Where can they go to find out exactly if they're in compliance?
You need to talk to the airline, I would say. But the only two safe things are make sure that you have everything powered up, everything powered up so that you can show have time. You're just going to have time and be patient. If somebody comes up to you at your gate, you think you're going in, you're already at the gate, you've gone through security, and they ask you to be screened again, just do it.
That's right, because it's all about security in the end. And we're going to have a lot more on our website as well. If you're flying and you need more information, you can go to CNN.com. Chris, thank you
you're
so
welcome.
Much.